Say, did you happen to hear the one about a comedian who made some wisecracks about God, only to find himself being investigated by the police for committing blasphemy? Well, actually, there's no punchline here, for this very situation occurred earlier this month and in a most unlikely place. Indeed, usually when you hear of someone being persecuted under a blasphemy law, the story tends to emanate out of a hardline Islamic Republic. So what does one make of comedian Stephen Fry being investigated by police for criminal blasphemy, not in Islamabad, but in Ireland? Recently, Irish police launched an investigation of the comedian after an interview aired on Irish television in which Fry described God as being capricious, mean-minded, stupid, and an utter maniac. Here's Fry in his own words.
And you walk up to the pearly gates and you are confronted by God. What will Stephen Fry say to him, her, or it?
I will basically, what's known as the Odyssey, I think, I'll say bone cancer in children. What's that about? How dare you? How dare you create a world in which there is such misery that is not our fault? It's not right. It's utterly, utterly evil. Why should I respect a capricious, mean-minded, stupid God who creates a world which is so full of injustice and pain? That's what I'd say.
And you think you're going to get in on that?
No, but I wouldn't want to. I wouldn't want to get in on his terms. They're wrong. Now, if I died and it was Pluto, Hades, and if it was the 12 Greek gods, then I would have more truck with it, because the Greeks were... they didn't pretend not to be human in their appetites and in their capriciousness and in their unreasonableness. They didn't present themselves as being all-seeing, all-wise, all-kind, all-beneficent. Because the God who created this universe, if it was created by God, is quite clearly a maniac, utter maniac, totally selfish.
Rhetoric aside, Fry does make some valid points when it comes to the age-old philosophical argument regarding the existence of an all-powerful God who is supposed to be loving and benevolent, yet seemingly turns a blind eye to so much misery in the world. Still, Ireland's Defamation Act clearly prohibits the, quote, publication or utterance of blasphemous matter, end quote. By the way, that Irish Blasphemy Act isn't some holdover from centuries ago. It was actually ratified in 2009. Now, the question remains, did Fry commit blasphemy by calling the Almighty One capricious, mean-minded, stupid, and an utter maniac? Well, I suppose if you're a devout believer in God, the answer is yes. But even if Fry did commit blasphemy, so what? In a society that values freedom of speech and expression, are we not also free to be blasphemous? Besides, if your religion is so fragile that it cannot endure being mocked via satire or jokes or caricatures, then really, how valid is your religion to begin with? In any event, at least the Fry case comes with a happy, albeit fittingly comical ending. You see, Irish police recently closed the case without actually charging Fry, because they had been, quote, unable to find a substantial number of outraged people, end quote. And it gets even funnier. In dropping their investigation, the police noted that even the original complainant didn't consider himself personally offended, so therefore there was no injured party to begin with. Maybe the real reason the complaint was filed was to challenge the ludicrous Irish Blasphemy Act. Who knows? Still, the Fry incident makes for a cautionary tale when it comes to our great dominion, which recently passed M103, a motion that condemns all forms of systemic racism and religious discrimination, but especially Islamophobia, of course. Those against M103, and count me amongst those masses, argue that this motion may one day lead to a bill that could lead to a law banning Islamophobia, which, by the way, is a term that still hasn't been defined. As well, given the changing demographics of Canada, why do I get this nervous feeling in my gut that, unlike the Stephen Fry case, Canadian police will easily find a substantial number of outraged people, thereby making persecution of those mocking Allah and or Muhammad a proverbial slam dunk? For the Rebel.media, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies. Like what you just saw? Then click subscribe below and never miss another Rebel video.